Hello friends, this is Dr. Ruchi Rai. Today we are going to discuss a very important topic which I really feel has been a source of a lot of anxiety among you all, that is PARC 3-step test. So we'll be talking about SOPALSY and what is PARC 3-step test. Before we go into this, let's revise a few important things regarding action of muscles. Of course, you all are very clear that when you are talking about action, horizontal muscles, very simple, I don't need to mention also. And coming to vertical muscles, the two important points that we keep in mind, let's revise this. Superiors are in tortus and recti are adductors. This makes our life simple to understand the action of different muscles. So let's keep this in mind when we are discussing PARC 3-step test. Also, another very important thing that we should revise here is whenever we talk about action of recti, we are talking about vertical muscles, mind it, okay? So when we talk about recti, the maximum action of recti is occurring in abducted position and a maximum action of oblique is always in an adducted position of the eye, okay? So this is what is written here, we will revise it again, that the maximum action of recti is always in an abducted position and for obliques it is in adducted position. If we are very clear with all this, now we come to what are the three steps of the PARC 3-step test. These are nothing but three questions we have to just answer. What is question number one? Which eye is hypertrophic? So the first question that we ask here is, which eye is hypertrophic? Now suppose we take an example here. Okay, it is the right eye, for example. What you have to, I hope you all know this, that it's always a protocol in a vertical squint that we mention the eye which is up. We will call this as a right hypertropia, we will call this as left hypertropia. We don't talk about hypo, we talk mainly about hyper. Anyway, so if you have a situation where the patient has a right hypertropia, so what are the options? Do you realize either the depressors of the right eye are responsible for this imbalance or elevators of the left eye? Correct? So either the depressors of right are affected or elevators of left eye are affected. So please keep this in mind when we are talking about this question, that if there is a right hypertropia, if for example, then the right eye depressors, what are the right eye depressors? It is right inferior rectus and right superior oblique. What are the left eye elevators? It will be left superior rectus and left inferior oblique. Is it clear? Again, I'm repeating. Think again with me. Right hypertropia, what depressors, what are the muscles which can be affected? It can be right superior oblique or right inferior rectus, or it could be left superior rectus or left inferior oblique. These are the elevators. Once we are clear that, okay, these are the four muscles in question, the second question of the PARC 3-step test is, in which gaze, so what this is the second question, in which lateral direction or gaze there is worst hypertropia. So now comes a very important point as we revised just now, that maximum action of recti will occur in abducted position, oblique and adducted. Coming to our example of right hypertropia, let's take both the cases to be very, very clear. If this hypertropia increases on opposite gaze, the left side, that means right eye is adducted, left eye is abducted, correct? So right eye superior oblique can be involved, or left eye superior rectus, that is the elevator of the left eye, and in abducted position, when the left eye is abducted, it is the recti which has to be involved, so it will be left superior rectus. So these are the two muscles in question if this hypertropia is increasing in left gaze. So to make it very, very clear to you all, let us also think together What if this right, this case of right hypertrophia, and what if it increases in the right gaze? Very simple again. If it increases in the right gaze, right eye recti muscle, left eye oblique muscle. Right eye, which recti is in question? Right eye depressus. That means right inferior rectus, or it could be left inferior oblique, that is elevated. Hope it's clear. So this is the second question we saw. Coming back to over this example, I'm saying it is a right hypertropia. I'm also saying, okay, this right hypertropia is increasing in opposite gaze. So what are the muscles that are in question now at present in this example? Is right superior oblique, or it could be left superior rectus. Come to the third question now. Talking about this third question, here it is, in which head tilt this hypertropia is worst. Take a tip from me here. If your head tilt is towards the higher eye is causing increase of hypertropia, that means same side head tilt causing increase of hypertropia, it is the obliques which are involved. And if the head tilt towards the lower eye is causing increase of hypertropia, it is the recti which are involved. Just take this tip, it becomes simple. Okay, back to the basics. Whenever you are tilting the head, whichever side, suppose in this example I say right side, then right eye needs, it had to intort, left eye needs to extort. Please understand that. Coming back to this example, it was right hypertropia which increased in opposite gaze. The two muscles in question were right superior oblique, left superior rectus. Now we talk about the third question, and the third step is I'm tilting the head to the same side, hypertropia increases. If tilting the head to the same side, hypertropia increases, what did I tell you? Obliques are involved, so my diagnosis is right superior oblique palsy. This increase of hypertropia on tilting the head on the same side is what you call Bilchowski's sign. Okay, so let's look here. This is what we are saying. So I think it's very, very clear in this child. What is shown here is left eye hypertropia. You have to see at the light reflex. In your right eye, it is exactly at the center of the pupil. In the left eye, this light reflex is seen lower down, right here. Look at this one. You know, this is the light reflex that we are talking about, which means it is the left eye which is hypertropic. Now tilting on the left side, you know, same side head tilt here. In the same side head tilt, what you see, hypertropia is increasing further, okay, which is not happening on the opposite side head tilt. This is again left esopalsy, so this is your Bilchowski's sign. Now coming to the point, why it is happening? Let's understand a little bit more here. We are talking about our example of right hypertropia, and I'm saying it is increasing on opposite gaze, and when I tilt the head on the same side, so what I'm trying to explain you, why is there increase of hypertropia on the same side head tilt? So what is happening is, when I tilt the head on the same side, to look straight, my eye needs to intort, as I told you, right eye needs to intort, and superiors are intorters, right? If there is a SO palsy, do you realize the whole onus of intorsion will go on superior rectus? If the superior rectus whole onus is going, what is the primary action of superior rectus? It is elevation. This is the reason of increase of hypertropia on same side head tilt. Am I clear? I repeat, on tilting the head, eye needs to intort. Because superior oblique is already paralyzed, the onus of intorsion goes on superior rectus. It overacts, leading to increase of hypertropia. This is what is Bilchowski's sign. Okay? So now when you have a exam question in your MCQ and you have to find the muscle, let us summarize it more quickly. We cannot really think in so much of detail at the exam time. So very, very simple. Come to the next slide here. Right hypertropia, suppose, you can apply it off the other side of course. increasing on any hypertropia, in this case it is right, increasing on the opposite gaze. So any hypertropia, we may not take it as right, but hypertropia which increases on opposite gaze and same side head tilt has to be esopalsy. So in this case, what I have written here is, it's a right hypertropia. So if it is increasing on the opposite gaze, on the same side head tilt, it will be right superior oblique palsy. So this is one of the very quick methods, and maximum questions that have been asked in your BG entrance is well managed and answered if you remember these two important points regarding esopalsy. Okay, so no more tensions, no more anxiety, no more making figures, cutting muscles, circling them. Just common sense, just understand what it is and how to quickly solve it. Hope it was helpful to you all. Thank you so much. And all of you, please work very hard and stay blessed.